Hey, what's up, guys? Gonna do a quick little unboxing. I usually do these on the weekends when I have a lot of time, but I felt like wearing some new gear to work, so I figured, you know what? Let me just go ahead and unbox this shit and wear it to work today and film a quick little video here. Speaking of work, it's been like really busy at the office. Like, it's crazy. I was having a conversation with my cousin who works with me at the office. He's not feeling so good right now, so hope you're feeling better, Tim, if you're watching this. But he was texting me last night just saying, like, he's exhausted. He's like, it's so busy at the office. And I totally empathize with that because I've been doing this for about 15 years. He's been doing it for like 4 or 5 now. I've been in that situation, had that feeling that he's been having. You know, just being overwhelmed at work because it's just so busy. What I told him was, you know, it's okay to feel overwhelmed. It's okay to feel like stressed out from work, and he should take some time off, take a breather, go relax. He deserves it. He works really, really hard. One thing I wanted to remind him though was like, hey, it's a good thing that we're busy, because when I first started my practice, it was not busy. It was slow and it was a scary time. I prayed to God a lot in those early days, like, oh my God, please tell me that I'm doing the right thing, that I'm not leading my wife down the wrong path, that this is not going to become like a total utter failure, because it was a massive risk coming out of law school and starting my practice. I think back in the day, it was like, you got to work in a law firm, gain experience. Once you have that experience, you can either continue to work towards making partner at the firm, or you can, you know, hang your own shingle and set up your own shop and go independent and have a little boutique firm for yourself and run your own little ship. Around year 6, we got so fucking busy. Like, it was, I built a reputation for myself. Our firm was becoming established. Phones were ringing off the hook. And I was just like, oh my God. Like right now, when is this gonna end? Hello, Eddie Kim speaking, how can I help you? But there was a time when we first started when it was not ringing, and then it got super duper busy. And I was like, oh my God, when is this gonna end? But it became a reality that I don't want this to end. If I'm trying to run a successful business, a successful law firm, you don't want the phones to stop ringing. You don't want to not be busy. This is what I wanted. I wanted to be overwhelmed. I wanted to be incredibly busy, because that is a sign of success. Once you're not busy, once you're not overwhelmed, that means you don't have anything to do. And if you don't have anything to do, then you're not running a successful law firm. I never want to go back to that time. You know, what's even more beautiful about being busy all the time, like, it's really dope to see, especially the people who have been at my firm for a long time. I've watched them grow from, you know, making $10 an hour to being able to grow into a position where now they're buying a house, buying a vacation home, buying cars, putting food on the table for their family. I mean, recently, one of my longest tenured guys, he just got engaged. People are having babies. It is fucking incredible to watch that. It's a really beautiful thing to watch, to see something grow literally from just dust, like an idea in my brain, to 15 years later, to see what we have now. I think it's incredible. One of the things that I hope, though, is that I hope that the people that work for me, they remember what it was like, especially some of my original employees, like, when times weren't so great, when it wasn't always expected that our phones ring. Like, I hope that they don't fall prey to comfort, because once you get comfortable and then you just start to plateau, that's not going to help with growth. That's also not even going to help sustain the level of success that we've achieved. It requires tremendous effort. Every single day, all day long. There is no room for rest. To scale, what we're doing now is not enough. And I think that's a tough pill for a lot of people to swallow. It's something that I learned a long time ago, is that sometimes your best is not enough. But just because I tell you that your best is not good enough, that's not to downplay your effort. What I'm trying to get at is your best is not good enough for us to get to the next level. Right now, if this is your best, then this is as far as we're gonna get. But there's always something to hone. And finding those things and getting better and better each day it's important to sustain success. But I don't want to shit on my guys. Don't think I'm saying like they're not working hard or that they've become complacent. And I don't even think my cousin Tim is, he's not even complaining. I just wanted to remind him, is like, hey, busy is good. We want to be busy. The last thing we want is to not be busy. And what I liked about this was it reminded me of kind of what I first fell in love with Fear of God for. It's got this like, this looks like a band tee, like a 90s band tee, you know? It has, there's some nostalgia here. Feels good, feels great. Typical of anything that's Fear of God. I don't know, I guess this is mainline. What does he say? He was despised and rejected by mankind, a man of suffering and familiar with pain. Like one from whom people hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him in low esteem. It's kind of fire, you know? Kind of looks like a Slipknot tee. That was a long sleeve t-shirt. This is a short sleeve t-shirt. Same quote in the back. This has an Apocalypse Now theme. I love that movie. The book is actually better, Heart of Darkness. The movie kind of drags and drags. I think, you know, as like someone who used to think he was going to make movies for a living, I pretended like I enjoyed Apocalypse Now because, you know, I wanted to be like hoity-toity and be like, oh my God, it's an amazing film by Francis Ford Coppola. It's like an amazing, was it Martin Sheen? It was like a crazy performance and they all went crazy while making it. And it was like this wildly out of control production that made this beautiful movie. But it's a drag to watch. It's a hard one to watch. But you know what is interesting is the documentary. So I think it was his wife. Can't remember because I'm doing this all off the top of my head right now. But I think his wife was there and doing like BTS stuff. And they filmed a making of documentary. And that shit is wild. That is actually, to me, the more important film of the two. But I digress. Apocalypse Now, a movie that I'm a fan of. Like, you know, that looks pretty cool. Again, band tee shit. Looks good. What size did I get? I got a size large. Looks like it's gonna fit really well. Glad I got a, it's not really white. It's like oat. And then finally, I picked up a pair of shorts, size medium. There we go. Nothing crazy. Are they unhemmed? Yeah, kind of like cut off shorts. Feels good, everything looks vintage. This is what I love about Fear of God. This is the Fear of God I miss. I think this is what people are saying when they say Fear of God has fallen off. It becomes so like clean. What is it, high-end fabrics. It's very like more geared towards being a luxury brand. While the Fear of God that I fell in love with was more vintage, more distressed, more rugged, more edgy, more rock and roll, more punk rock, more heavy metal. So when I saw that they Fear of God did this collab, I was like, I fuck with this more so than even this, you know. All right, I gotta get to fucking work.
One is the loneliest number that you'll ever do. Two can be as bad as one. It's the loneliest.
I feel super lucky that I get to dress how I want to dress at work. You know, being my own boss is pretty cool. And that creating and nurturing like a environment and culture at a professional office like a law firm where you can kind of just be yourself and not having to be all stuffy and wear a suit all the time. I think that's pretty cool. Hey, what's up? Hey, Nishun, how are you? Good to see you.
Nice seeing you too.
Hey, what's up, Nishun? And the day is done. Oh my God. It's a crazy day. But I got a compliment from a client about my shirt. So in keeping with like the military theme of this Apocalypse Now Fear of God shirt, I wore my Vayer Korean War veteran field watch, and I got my West Point hat on. Shout out to Hewan, my cousin. He just enrolled at West Point. Really proud of him. He's a cadet. just got through boot camp, and he's a freshman at West Point. Pretty cool. Really smart kid. I think he scored like a 1600 on his SATs, 4-point-something GPA. Honestly, he could have gone to any fucking college he wanted to go to, and I was like, why are you going to West Point? Isn't that, like, not that competitive? But I realized, you know, he's committed to something else beyond academics. You know, he's joining the military of the greatest country in the world. So, shout out to Hewlett. Super proud of you. But I was just looking at myself and I was like, I'm fucking stupid. Like, why am I dressed like this? I think I just had a shitty day at work. Going back to what I was talking about earlier, just not complaining about being busy. I don't want to say I'm complaining about busy, but when you are busy, it is overwhelming. And it does take a lot out of me. I should feel very blessed and fortunate. And I do. I can't say that I don't feel those things. But when you're busy, you're tired. I wonder if there's a way to just, like, embrace that overwhelming feeling, the burden, the pressure of running a successful business, and just, like, enjoying that. Like, I wonder if that's possible. If you run a business, let me know in the comments. When you're just, like, grinding it out on the day-to-day, can you just say, like, I love the grind? Now, watch people like Gary Vee who claim that they love the grind. I'm trying to adopt that mentality, but you get a day like today and you get beat the fuck up, sometimes it's hard to think about the blessings. You're just being ground down to a nub after work. You know what? Fuck that bullshit. This is why I don't vlog on the weekdays, because I start feeling sorry for myself. I'm talking to myself like my life is bad. No, my life is so fucking awesome. I'm literally my own boss. I run a really awesome firm. I work with amazing people. I have amazing clients. The fuck am I complaining about? It could be so much fucking worse. I saw a homeless dude sleeping on the ground right across the street. You know, that could fucking be me. So, I need to shut the fuck up. Learn to be grateful. I don't want to end the video on such a sour note, like me, like, complaining about work, or me, like, just, like, shit-talking myself like that. Got back home, enjoying the beautiful view, pondering the meaning of life, and I think it's okay. I think it's totally fine to be stressed out at work. What sparked this whole conversation is, you know, my cousin hitting me up yesterday and just telling me, like, I need a break, I'm tired, I'm stressed because it's so busy at work. And my response to him was, this is what success is. Being busy is success. So embrace it. I think that's a little bit unfair, because it's easier said than done. And today is like a day that really proves that. I was really overwhelmed at work. As an attorney, nobody calls me because things are going well. People are calling me because shit hits the fan. I think it's okay that even if life is good, to complain. I try not to complain about my life, because, you know, I do feel blessed and I am grateful for, you know, everything in my life, my family, my friends, my business. You really can't ask for much more than that. But I think it is unfair of me to say that I'm not allowed to complain about anything because my life is good. Running a successful business is stressful. It comes with the territory. Is it all worthwhile? I think so. I'm really, really good at what I do. I'm an expert in my field. I'm respected by my colleagues. My clients love me. My employees, they go to bat for me. I'd like to say that they love me, but who knows? I'm pretty tough on them. And let's not beat around the bush here. My business is lucrative. So yeah, it's definitely worth it. I want to find this balance where I don't feel guilty for complaining about my life because it's good, but complaining about things that, the aspects of my life that are stressful, I should feel okay. I should feel secure in complaining, not have an overwhelming sense of guilt just because I've got it good. And I also want to know how to embrace the challenges and the stress and the burden. And maybe there isn't a balance. Maybe that's just what all of this is, you know? It's just like this huge pot of everything. That's life. You get the good, you got the bad, you got the stress, you got the good clients, the bad clients, You got the backstabbers, you got the haters, you got the supporters. Dreams come true, nightmares become reality. I mean, it's just a big old just pot of everything. And that's what life is, and just enjoy it all, the good and the bad. Easier said than done. But Tim, if you are specifically watching this, man, I want to let you know that I'm really proud of you. You're working so hard. I completely understand why you're stressed. And it's okay to feel that burden. It's okay to feel tired. You're human. I'm glad we had that conversation last night, because today was a rough day. And I came out and I was like doing my best to pretend like, oh man, no, this is it. This is what I signed up for. This is what I asked for. It's gonna be a rough day. It's gonna be a rough ride. But I started this business, so this is what I should get. And I need to just embrace it and enjoy the moment, because this is what success is. But I couldn't. It was hard. I came out of the office today just like beat the fuck up. And I felt guilty for feeling beat up. I don't want to feel guilty about that. I'm allowed to have a bad day. My life is not bad, and my bad day is probably not as bad as someone else's bad day, and it's all relative, but I'm human. And Tim, you're human. Being stressed from being busy, man, that's totally normal. I'm sorry if I dismissed those feelings last night in that conversation. I had no right to do that. You're amazing. I love you. I'll see you at the office when you're feeling better. Everyone watching this video, thanks for just listening to me ramble. It's very therapeutic for me. I hope you enjoyed the Fear of God RRR 123 collab unboxing too. I love it. At least I look good while I'm complaining, right?